people who are living the reality of the healthcare battle. Pastor Janice Hill says her daughter would have died without Obamacare, and Bob Riscoe is a Trump voter who signed up for Obamacare. Thank you both for joining us this evening. So let's talk about this. This is a real impact. Pastor, you first. Your daughter's name is Amy, had a very rare cancer for 4 years now. How is she doing?
Yes. She's hanging in there. Every kind of treatment that she's been on since her diagnosis 4 years ago has been experimental. So things will work for a while and then they'll stop working and get something new, and something new has been added, and they're just learning all the time.
Mm-hmm. So you confronted West Virginia Senator Caputo with your daughter's story. I want to watch that and then we'll talk about it.
That's my daughter.
Okay.
Yes, she is beautiful. She doesn't take after her mom, but that's okay. But now I want to want you to see her in treatment.
Oh my
God. Okay.
How old is she?
She's 41 years old. She's been fighting this cancer.
Is her name Amy?
Amy Elizabeth Stills. Mm-hmm. She's been fighting this cancer for 4 years, very diligently, has maintained her job, has gotten promotions, has led teams, as sick as she has been. She would not be alive today if it wasn't for the ACA.
So, Pastor, you have shared those pictures with us.
Wow.
That you were showing the senator in that video. In the video before she got the cancer,
correct,
you see that on the left, and then you see her during the cancer fighting it. Do you think that she really understood your situation?
Understood. I'm not sure. I think she heard what I had to say, and I think she listened to what I had to say. But I don't, that is not something that gives me a lot of comfort. I want her to act on it, because it's not just my daughter. That's a face that I hope she will have in her mind when she is voting. But Amy is one of thousands and millions of people that this horrible, immoral bill is going to affect.
Bob, I'm going to bring you now, because you're a lifelong Republican, yet you and your wife are insured,
yes,
through the ACA, through Obamacare. What will happen to that insurance,
yes,
if Obamacare is repealed?
We probably won't be insured.
You okay?
Yes, we won't be insured if Obamacare goes away.
Mm-hmm.
We won't be able to afford premiums.
So do you know what it would cost you to get insurance on an open market? And could you afford that?
I know we can't afford it. It's over $1,000 a month.
Yeah.
So I don't know the exact number, but it's...
Yeah.
Please go ahead.
No, I'm... Finish your thought, but that's fine. So it would be incredibly hard on you financially. That's what you're saying.
Absolutely. We wouldn't be able to afford coverage without the Affordable Care Act.
So you voted for Donald Trump even though he promised to repeal the program you rely on. Why is that?
Because I think that hopefully they'll bring about something that will be fiscally sound and last. I do think that Obamacare does have problems, and they do need to get fixed. I hope that there's something that will be in place that we can still have coverage for myself and a lot of others.
So I want to ask you this, because you know, everything in Washington is politicized, right? The political capital of the world, if you will. Do you think there's too much politics here? Do you care if Obamacare is repealed or replaced, or do you just want a better health care system? Do you care what it's called or whose name is on it?
That's a good question. I hope that there'll be some kind of health care available to the public. I think it's important. It's important for quality of life, and it's just something that I hope that they'll evolve, that it will be long-term, that we can count on it and not worry about not being covered.
Mm-hmm. Do you think they should slow down, or are you okay with the timeline that they've set up? Because it appears that right now they don't have the votes. They may by the end of the week. Who knows? Mitch McConnell wants a vote by the 4th of July weekend. Do you see the rush?
I'm not sure. I would like them to take the time to do the best that they can do to try to put something in place where there'll be still some help to people of my age bracket and help out others that need the coverage as well.
Yeah. Pastor, do you think by talking with the senator and talking to other people, do you think that that will help influence? Are you looking to help influence the vote? Do you think that will influence the vote?
You have no idea how desperate I am to get people to look at this bill, to see what's happened. Why was it done in such secret? Why is there such a rush to get it done? It doesn't make sense. And the very people that have voted, our two senators, Senator Manchin and Senator Capito, in, are the ones that are going to be so desperately hurt. We are in a very poor state. And when they take away Medicaid, it is not only going to hurt my daughter, who is not on Medicaid now because she's working full-time, but it is going to hurt the people in my state. It's going to hurt veterans, which I'm a veteran. You know, 10% of the veterans are on Medicaid. It's going to hurt. We're a rural state. And a pharmacist in one of my churches said, Janice, this is going to ruin hospitalization because little hospitals in a rural area will go out of business. That's mm-hmm. going to hurt the employment rate. It's going to hurt people's access to health coverage. And so, of course, they're not going to go for any kind of preventative care. It's going to be critical when they do go, which is going to cost more money. This bill just doesn't make sense.
Okay. Pastor, thank you, and wish your daughter the best. Bob, thank you for coming on. We know it's not easy to come on and share your story like this to the stories like this to the world, but we appreciate you coming on. Thank you so much.
Very good. Thank you.
When we come back, breaking news out of Syria.